Today in Balsei's studios we are going to speak about Arraigo Social, this exceptional residence permit of Spain. My name is Christian Balsei's, I'm the CEO of Balsei's Group, and I will develop all what you need to know in order to be aware of the requirements to get Arraigo Social, this exceptional authorization. We will divide the presentation in two parts. The first part would be to define what is Arraigo Social, and the second part would be to explain all the requirements and go into details in each requirement. Let's start with the presentation. What is Arraigo Social? What does it mean, Arraigo Social? Arraigo Social, in the concept, means when the tree gets into the land. So this, in comparison with the immigrants, means that when an immigrant stays in Spain for more than 3 years as irregular, we understand that he already made his life in Spain, so there is the possibility to get these exceptional authorizations because he has been living irregular in Spain for several years, for 3 years, and established his life in the country. It's very important to know that during these 3 years, this person cannot be out of Spain for more than 120 days. This is a very crucial point because there is some immigrants that they are irregular in Spain, but they travel a lot, and then they don't accomplish the requirement of, during these 3 years, not more than 120 days out of a country. So this is an exceptional authorization that the state of Spain gives for those that, besides that they have been illegal, irregular, 3 years, the public administration considers that they already started a life in Spain, like the tree, no? They plant themselves on the land of Spain, so they give the possibility to regularize their situation and to get a residence permit. It's very important to have ways to prove that you have been these 3 years in Spain, irregular, illegal. Last thing about what is arraigo, also remember that, for example, I come to Spain, I get a student permit, I study, and then I cannot renew it and I decide to stay in Spain. These years will count for the arraigo social. So you don't need to be during these 3 years irregular, it can count as well the years that you have been regular, but is in total. When you submit the application, you are irregular and you have been 3 years in Spain, this would be enough to apply for Arraigo Social, this exceptional authorization as a residence permit. Let's go now into the requirements. Very important to listen to the requirements because Arraigo Social is one of the most technical permits that we have in Spain, and it's as well popular because there is a lot of people that unfortunately they cannot renew their permits, or they come here as a tourist, they want to remain in Spain, and they have to be for these 3 years illegal in order to be able to change the status to a resident. The requirements are as follows. The first requirement would be to fill a form. It's a special form for Arraigo Social. Our office can help you with this. Another document would be the full copy of the passport. It's very important here that the entry stamp in Spain is, meaning that you have been these 3 years since the entry in the country and that you have not been traveling. Be careful, because if they see that there is entry and exit stamps from Spain during this period, it's more than 120 days, this could affect your application and it could be a reason of rejection. Another document that we will need to provide is a way to prove that you have been in Spain. And normally our advice is to provide the empadronamiento, the registration at the city town, that it has to match with these 3 years. So if you are planning to do arraigo social, most important is to be careful with the empadronamiento. If you don't have empadronamiento, the law allows to prove through other ways, such as medical certificates, bank accounts, any kind of public documents that you would have that could prove this 3 years in Spain. But in general, and it's the easiest, and it's already accepted by the immigration, the empadronamiento would be the best way to prove it. Then you will need to provide a work contract to be able to apply for arraigo social. This work contract, since the last modification in EGOS of 2022, is more flexible. It has to be a work contract for a period of at least a year. It has to be the minimum salary, which is around 1,000 euros per month. So the net salary would need to be the 1,000 euros per month. Also about the hours, it can be a 30 hours contract. It can be 40, but it can be even 30. And if you have kids, it can be 20 hours. This is another modification. Before it was only full-time contract, and the duration of more than 12 months. Now, they are more flexible with the long of the contract and as well with the hours. It can be 30, you have a kid, it can be even 20. It can be multiple contracts, so it can be two contracts of 20 hours. This is another new thing of the law. But at least you need to keep this 12,000 euros as a salary annually. So this is very important. Another requirement would be an interview with the social services. Here in Catalonia, it's managed by the city town. Basically, what they want to see is that you are integrated in the community, that you have already some knowledge of Spanish, that you know people, that you don't have any records with the police, so they want to see that you are a profile that could be admitted for this permit. Basically, this would be the most important documents of the file. Once we get the approval from the social services, we can then submit the application online. Preparing the documents plus the application could take 3 to 4 months, so it's not a fast-track process, but if you go with a lawyer, like we can offer you one of Balsays Group, it's very important to do the things correctly in order to reach the result, the residence permit. The issue is not the time, it's to make it happen, to make it correct, and to have all the documents. So once we have all these documents, we submit them online through a lawyer in a platform, it's called Mercurio, and after 2-3 months, we receive the positive answer, and then the work contract came into effect, and the immigrant or the client will get the residency card, valid for 1 year, then the renewal is for 4 years. This would be, in general, Arraigo, the requirements and the process. In the case that you don't have a work contract, there is other ways to prove financial resources. One would be to prepare a business plan that it has to be approved by an association. And then you could get the Arraigo Social as a business developer, as a business owner, so self-employed person, freelancer, contractor. Well, there is all these ways to define this position. Another option would be to get the Arraigo Social because you have enough resources to live in Spain without work. This would be around 10-12,000 euros. You can contact us and we can explain you more in detail the process, and we can even represent you during all the immigration process. Our lawyers, they can contact the company to prepare the contract, to help you with the taxes, with the forms, with the appointments, with everything. So don't forget Balsays Group. If you need help on immigration, you can contact us by email, by phone, in our social networks, and as well, don't forget, the most important, to subscribe in our YouTube channel, because through this channel, you will get knowledge not just in Arraigo, in other immigration procedures, tips on taxes, on business, on everything that you would need in order to reside in Spain well informed. Thank you very much.